Let's start with the journey of the sixth chapter, guys, that is rights and duties. Guys, we basically know, guys, ki rights and duties hote hai har aadmi ke towards the nation. He has right to vote. Similarly, he has duty to safeguard the asset of people. That means everybody has a right to get into the bus. And then it's his duty that the public property ko nasht nahi karna. He should not make any, bad thing for the public property. He should not damage the public property. That is his duty. So this is the basic rights and duties which go hand to hand, and we'll study this only in our sixth chapter. Let's jump into the introduction, guys. Rights are generally defined as justified claims for protection of general interest. That means these are justified claims that are used for protection of what? General interest. Logo ka jo common interest hai, usko bachane ke liye, we generally have this rights. Rights and duties are complementary and are inseparable. That means wherever we have rights, there will be duties, like right to ticket hai, right to equality. If at all you want to board a bus, you can board. There is no problem. Provided there is a duty also not to damage that public property. So if you discharge your duties, well, you will automatically get the rights. That means if you discharge your duties, you will as well as automatically discharge your rights also. As the citizen has to rights and duties, so has the state. Like people will have their rights and duties. Similarly, the country, the state will also have various rights and duties. The one is incomplete without each other. That means state and man or individuals are not complete if at all they don't have rights and duties for each other. They both need to be there so that there is something called rights and duties. Every individual is expected to recognize and respect the rights of fellow individuals. So every individual should be expected that he should respect the right of other individuals. Let's understand the meaning and definition of rights. Meaning of rights. Rights are common claims of people which every cultured society recognizes as essential claim for development and which are therefore enforced by the state. That means these are common claims, right to speak, right to vote. These are common claims that a civilized society should have, cultured society should have, which are essential for development and hence enforced by the state. Let's understand the various definitions of right. Ernest Barker defined rights as rights are external conditions necessary for development of capabilities of personality of individual. So these are external conditions which are necessary for development of the capability of individuals. Similarly, Bosanquet a right is a claim recognized by society and enforced by the state. That means it's a claim that is recognized by the society, which is accepted by the society and is enforced by whom? The state or the country. T.H. Green has defined rights as, rights are those powers claimed and recognized as contributory to common good. That means these are those powers which are recognized and are claimed to be contributory for common good. State ke common good ke liye, there are few rights that should be there. There are some powers that should be there in hands of individual. They are generally known as rights according to T.H. Green. John Rawls actually defined rights as each person is to have an equal right to most extensive basic liberty compatible with the similarity of liberty for others. That means that every person should have rights which is similar, that is exercised by others. So sabko equal rights hona chahiye, equal libertized rights hona chahiye. That means equal freedom should be there for everyone in a society. So this was about the meaning and definition of rights. Thank you.